Welcome back. Using PyTorch, how about getting more performance using almost the same code? How about running on the latest Intel GPUs? Let me tell you all about Intel extension for PyTorch. I'll start with the bottom line. I'm training ResNet 50. On the left side, PyTorch on Intel Max CPU. In the middle, same CPU, same training, now using Intel extension for PyTorch. Right side, Intel extension for PyTorch on the Intel Max GPU. I think the value is pretty obvious. Better performance, better memory consumption, and much more. You all want to write code in higher level, Python-like environment, but you expect, or at least hope, for the best performance. In order to achieve this performance, on whatever hardware you're using, Intel is using oneAPI optimized libraries like OneDNN, the neural network library, the OneMKL math kernel libraries, and others. Check out my other videos on each of these libraries. These libraries are multi-device, multi-vendor, and multi-instruction set, so you can get the hardware acceleration of DLBoost, AVX 512, AMX, and more. On top of them, you can find quite a few optimization tools and improvements to the driver and the runtime. Intel is continuously contributing to the open source PyTorch and introduces these improvements to the community whenever possible. But some features and enhancements are not upstreamed yet. You can only find these features in the Intel extension for PyTorch. The changes required for your code in order to use the Intel extension for PyTorch are minimal, as I'll show you in a minute. If you navigate to the Intel extension for PyTorch page, I'll leave you that link, you'll notice that there are two versions, one for CPUs and one for Intel GPUs or XPUs. Beside the fact that this is currently the only way to run on Intel latest GPUs, you can see here a list of features to enhance performance. And if you go to technical details, you can learn all about the graph optimizations, memory management, and more. Installation, make sure you have the right platform. Check out my other video on the oneAPI base toolkit, a very useful toolkit to have. Pay attention that Windows is not supported yet, but you can run it on WSL. It works for me. You'll need the extension version that corresponds to the right PyTorch version. This one line of installations just work. And if you're using Intel optimized Python, use this line. A good place to get started is the code examples. You got here code for training or for inference, and it's really useful that the extension specific code is highlighted very clearly. Let's use it for example. I'm connected to the Intel Developer Cloud. Let's run an example from scratch. From the examples, training, I'll take the ResNet 50 training example as is. I'll start with PyTorch, the regular stock PyTorch. So I will not import the extension and I'll remove this line too. And I'll replace all the XPU with CPU. So running PyTorch on CPU. Let's run it. I'm using Sapphire Rapid, a very powerful CPU. Still, this is very heavy operation and it takes about 6 seconds per batch. Now, just see how simple it is to move to the Intel extension for PyTorch. I'll just add this line, import the extension, and use it to optimize the model. Two lines. I'm still running on CPU, but now using IPEX. Model is loading and each batch now takes almost half, about 3 seconds. And move into the GPU. Change all the CPU to XPU or of course any other target device, and now using Intel Max 1100 GPU, running the Intel extension for PyTorch, you can see that the runtime is totally different. This is a great return of investment, change 2-3 lines of code and run much faster on the same platform. There are many code examples in the oneAPI code samples GitHub. Check out the video description for more links. Intel extension for PyTorch. Enjoy. Subscribe. Thank you.